हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई एम स्निग्धा वर्मा अगेन विथ यू इस लेसन नंबर 6 ऑफ एलियन हैंड. आई वॉन्ट समथिंग इन अ केज. दिस लेसन इज अबाउट अ पर्सन मिस्टर पर्सेल हु वॉज अ पेट शॉप ऑनर एंड अबाउट हिज पिक्यूलियर कस्टमर. हिज कस्टमर वॉज अ प्रिजनर एंड ही हैड फीलिंग अबाउट द बर्ड्स एंड एनिमल्स. So what did he do that you will see in this chapter? Mr. Purcell had a pet shop. He was a small man. He had red cheeks and a tight melon stomach. He wore large glasses. His eyes looked big through them. He had the appearance of a wise and genuine oil because he had stomach like melon and he was very short in height and he had red cheeks also and he used to sit on high stool also. So this all give him an appearance of an oil. Mr. Purcell sold cats, dogs and monkeys. He sold fish food and bird seeds also. He gave advice for sick animals and he suggested remedies for them as well. He displayed beautiful cages in his shop. There were rows of cages on his shelf. He thought that he was a professional man. The shop had less light and it was full of noises. One could hear twitters, rustling, squeals, chirps and squeaks. These are all are the noise and cries of the birds and animals. Small birds ran in circle in fear. Thus there was life in his shop, but it smelled of confined flesh. Anyhow, the customers were always happy. They came and praised the birds. They called them sweet and cute. Mr. Purcell was very happy to see such customers. He often smiled and nodded his head when people praised the birds. Mr. Purcell had a fixed routine. He opened his shop. He fixed everything at its place. Then he sat on a stool that and began to read the morning newspaper. He would enjoy every item of news. He did not leave even the advertisement columns. One day Mr. Purcell was sitting at his shop. The day was cold and a strong wind was blowing. A thin sheet of smoke covered the whole city. Mr. Purcell came to his shop. He completed his usual task. He sat on the stool and began to read the newspaper. The noise in the shop did not disturb him as it was as familiar to him as the ticking of a clock. But he often heard the bell. The bell rang at the coming of the customer. A strange thing happened that morning. He did not hear the bell. However, he saw a man standing inside the door. He rubbed his hands out of habits. He smiled and nodded too. The man who came into his shop was pale-faced. He was wearing new but loose clothes. He did not look at Mr. Purcell, but he looked all around the shop. Mr. Purcell was upset. He did not know what to say. Anyhow, he exchanged greetings with a smile. He asked his customer what he wanted. The customer replied, "I want something in a cage." The shopkeeper wanted clarification, but the customer said him that, "I mean what I said. I do not want rats. I want something with wings. I want something that flies." Mr. Purcell knew what the customer wanted. He showed him a pair of fine doves. He demanded $5.50 as a price. The stranger had just $5 with him. He told the shopkeeper that it was all that he had. This was his total earning in 10 years. He was in prison. The prison was like a cage for him. He was given a $5 bill at the end of his term. The shopkeeper knew that he was earning a good profit even at that price. So he gave the pair to the customer, obliging him for $5. Mr. Purcell wanted to say something more, but the stranger was not interested. He went out with the cage. Mr. Purcell thought that the man was mad. He went to the window. When he looked out, he saw a strange sight. His customer stood outside his shop. He opened the cage, caught one dove, and let it fly in the air. He set the other doves free too. Then he dropped the cage and went away. He knew the value of freedom, so he wanted to free the birds. The shopkeeper was puzzled. He caged birds and earned money out of their sale. But here was a man who gave all his money, which he earned in 10 years in hard labor. He all gave all the money for their freedom. So when he realized the difference between the attitude of that person or between him, then he felt vaguely insulted. So students, you've seen that the person who was in prison, he knew the feeling of the prisoner. So he spent all his money, what he earned in 10 years, to free the birds. And this person, he was a shop owner. He used to sell birds and animals. So he used to keep them in cage and he used to sell them and then he earned his money. So there is a difference between the attitude of both the persons. So when Mr. Purcell realized this, then he felt insulted. So we have seen this lesson is over. So if you have any problem, you can ask. Have a nice day. Thank you.